Hello guys, my name is Kiki, and in this video we are going to work on another switch, and I am trying to repair this switch that I bought on eBay as not turning on. So at first let's check how it looks like. I can tell you that it's in a really mint condition. Hopefully this is one which was never opened before. As you can see at the bottom, it's from 2020, so it's a pretty new one. There are no scratches on it. It's really good. Let me check the charging port at first. And I can immediately tell. I don't know if I can show this. Yes, I can show this on camera. As you can see, all the pins on this side are jammed, so I will definitely not connect this to the USB until I replace it, the USB-C port. This side is maybe okay, but anyway. So let's first take it apart. Yes, so hopefully it was never taken apart. It looks in mint condition. The first thing I'm going to do is remove the motherboard and I will remove the USB-C port because it's jammed up. For sure I do not want to turn it on this way. So I will take it apart further to remove the motherboard from the case. So the motherboard is out. Let's first do a short inspection. I cannot see any blown components yet, so this is a good sign. But let me proceed with the removal of the USB-C port. First I will clean up the paste. Okay, so let me add some low melt solder. So now I will put it on my board holder, and then I can heat it. I can heat it from the top. And now I will heat it from the bottom with my hot air station, and I will let it fall off on its own. And as you could see, it just fall off on its own. And hopefully all the pins are intact this way. So let me go back under the microscope. Okay, so as you can see, all the pins are nice and intact. So now I will do some measurements with my multimeter to check if we have any shorts somewhere. Let's start with the fuse. If it's okay or not. Yes, the fuse is okay. It's really strange, it almost never blows. Let's measure this small filter. Okay. Okay. Let's measure the capacitors around M92. This is supposed to be ground. Okay, so hopefully our P13 USB survived. No short here, this is supposed to be ground. No short. No short, no short, no short, no short, and no short. This is ground. No short, no short, this is ground, and no short. Really good. This looks like our M92 is okay, at least based on this. Let's check our BQ chip. This ground, no short. This ground, no short. Ground, no short. No short, ground, ground, no short, really good. Let's measure the coil. Okay, it's okay. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do is that I have no shorts. Maybe I will check the other side around P13 insert in USB. And we check these small filters here. So everything measures good. Let's measure the capacitor and no short here. Supposed to be ground. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do is I will put it together and I'll try to turn it on with a known good battery. I will not put back at the moment the USB port. I will check if it works, and if it works, then afterwards I will replace the USB port also. I will switch back to my phone. Okay, so let me put it back to the case. Okay, so I just put in the connectors that are necessary to turn it on. I will connect now a known good battery. Because most probably this one is fully depleted because it was shorted. I mean the pins were shorted, so. Okay, so let's turn it on. Let's try our luck. And it turns on. To be honest, I'm not sure if I ever met with a switch where the pins were jammed up so strangely and I did not have to change a single chip. Okay, so for sure we do not know if it's charging or not, because the USB port is definitely out now, so I cannot connect it to the charger. But that it turns on, it's definitely a really good sign already. So what I will do now, I will remove it from the case once again, and I will put in a brand new USB-C port, and let's see if it's charging. Okay, so now I will add flux because I have to clean up the pads. I have to definitely remove the low melt solder because I do not want it to remain on the board, and I will just gently wick off the solder now. so as you can see, there is a small remaining thing inside the wall, but it's not a problem. Now I will add fresh leaded solder to the pins and try to avoid the holes basically. Now we clean it up again. Okay, so basically now our board is prepared. Let me grab a new USB-C port. And what I'm going to do, I will add flux to the pins. And I'm going to add just a little bit of tin on the pads, on the port. That's it. This will also help a little bit to have a little bit more solder on the pins. So now I will go back to my other board holder, and I will switch back to my camera. Okay, and what I'm going to do, I will add flux we'll put on the port. I cannot put it fully in because a little bit of solder remained inside the hole. But what I'm going to do, I will grab my hot air station, I will heat it from the bottom, and while I'm doing so, I'm pressing on the pin and it will just settle into position, hopefully. This is used to work. And this way I can fully save basically the port from the heat. This you can see there is zero melting on it, and due to the reason that I am melting it from the bottom, when the outer pins, when the solder and the outer pins are melted, I can be sure that also the solder and the inner pins are melted this way. If you would do this from the top, then this would not be sure, because the outer pins are exposed, but the inner ones are hidden. But this way it's not a problem. Let me show you this under the microscope. So as you can see, the port itself is not melted at all. Let me check if the pins are connected. Yes, it looks like all the pins are connected. Okay, so let's clean it up. Okay, let me solder also the back pins. Okay, so let's add some flux. Okay, so now we have nice and shiny joints. Let's clean up this side also. Okay, and now let's try to put it together. Okay guys, so I put it together, just enough for testing. I will not put on the heatsink at the moment, I just want to test if it works, because maybe something is wrong and I have to take it apart again. I will use my known good battery, because most probably the other one is bad. And then let me turn it on. Okay, it still turns on, which is a good sign. Touch works, there are a lot of games on it. And let's see if it's charging. And yes, it's charging. Let me show you also on the current meter, it's charging with 15 volts and 600 milliamps. Cool. Let me flip the cable over. And it's charging also in this way with the same 650 milliamps and 15 volts. Really cool. Okay, let me connect some Joy-Cons. Is connected now. I think it's not. Fan is spinning. Ah, okay. I did not connect it. I did not connect perfectly. Let me see if I did not connect this Joy-Con cable, so I have to reconnect it. I have to turn it off at first. Remove the battery. Let's turn it on again. And now it's connected. Controller synchronized. The right one is also connected. Yes, and the controllers are charging. Fan was spinning, so it's also okay. Usually if the fan is not spinning, then also the Joy-Con controllers the Joy-Cons are not charging because they are on the same 5 volt circuit. And one thing to find out if it works is the Wi-Fi. Go to internet settings. And let me change a little bit the contrast, you can see better. And Wi-Fi works great. Okay, so there would be one additional thing to try out, but unfortunately I cannot do this. The docking, if it docks or not. Unfortunately, my dock is dead now, so I cannot try this function. But I think it should be good. Let's see if the fan is spinning. Yes, as you can see, the fan is spinning and it's starting to be a little bit warm. So I will turn it on, off, and I put on new thermal paste and I will check also if the original battery works, but maybe not. I have doubts because it was discharged maybe for months, and it was deep discharged because of the shorted pins, but let's see if it works. Okay guys, so as you can see, this was a rather simple fix. I did not have to change any chips, only the USB-C connectors. I can tell you that this is really, really rare. Maybe I only had it once when the USB-C port was jammed. I don't know if you can see it now here. Look at this. All the pins are jammed inside. All of them. It's really crazy. So I was really lucky that it did not kill any of the chips. Okay guys, so this was this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If yes, please don't forget to like, share this video, and please subscribe to my channel. And I hope I see you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye.